Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Shafer here. So last week I showed you how to fold this decorative ball, and I showed you how you can stick an origami hook in here, and it is an origami ornament. And for this model, click right here. Well, this week I'm going to show you how to make this thing, the arrow hook. So, ready, set, here it goes. So this model I folded from this decorative paper. It's called chiogami. Well, I'm just going to show you how to fold it out of an ordinary 6-inch square of kami. So, ready, set, here it goes. So let's start out by, what are we going to do? Oh yes, fold in half diagonally. And fold in half again, like this. And unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this corner to this point. And unfold. And now let's fold this corner to the intersection of the creases. And let's turn over right to left. And let's fold this corner up to the top. And unfold. And once again, let's fold it to the intersection of the creases. Okay, now let's turn over right to left and rotate. And now let's fold this edge to the middle crease. And rotate. And let's fold this edge to here. And unfold, and now let's fold this edge to this crease. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to this crease. And unfold, and now let's fold this edge to the nearest crease. And unfold, and let's fold this edge to the nearest crease. And unfold, and let's turn over right to left and rotate. So now we're going to lift up this second crease, not this crease, but the next one down. Pinch it between your fingers so that it lifts up, and we're going to place it on the first crease. So place it down on that crease and flatten. And when we flatten, you see we make a new valley fold right in between these two creases. So flatten it down. And now we're going to take the next crease, this one, and lift it up and flatten it onto this edge. Okay, and let's take the next crease and lift it up. Now when you lift it up, notice at the bottom, you want to make sure that this corner gets folded through all layers. So just squeeze it like that. So it's folded through all layers. Okay, lift it up and bring it onto this edge. And continue down in the same manner. Just lifting up the edge and flattening it down on the edge above it. And now let's fold this edge up to this edge. And lastly, let's turn over top to bottom and fold on this crease like this and rotate 180 degrees and let's fold this edge to the top. Okay, so this is what it should look like. Now what we're going to do is turn over and reach in and pull this corner out, and you want to just carefully pull it out as far as it goes comfortably. And let's do the same thing on this side. So just reach in however you can and pull the flap up like that. Okay. And now try to make these pleats again, just reform them. Just squeeze them together. Like that. And just, you might have to pull them out a little bit more just to make them come out. And maybe pull this out a little bit. You want these to be pulled out the same amount because this is the arrowhead or the hook. And so that's okay like that, but if you want to make them look a little bit more balanced, then you can do a little reverse fold like that. This isn't really necessary. I just tuck that corner in. And on this side, a little reverse fold. I'm folding this corner up to this point. And you see, now they have the same look to them. Although this one is white and this one is green, but you get the idea. Okay, so here we have the arrowhead. And now we're going to hook these two together. And this will be the hook where you can put it in. But we can make this a lot bigger. So I'm going to just show you how to do that. So let's turn over like this and let's make it really big. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this edge and fold it to this edge. So we're bisecting this angle, and you just want to fold it down to the first crease, right, like that. And let's do the same thing on this side. So let's take this edge and fold it to this edge. Okay, and so I'm gonna just mark these two points. This is point A, and this is point B where these creases cross. And now let's make a fold that attaches point A and point B. So open it out like this and make a valley fold that connects point A and point B. Just like that. And now squeeze here and squeeze here. And press it up like that. Okay? Now let's turn over right to left. And let's bring these two edges together, just like this, so that it goes to the nearest crease. And the same on the right side. Let's bring these two edges together. And here we have our point C and our point D. Let's make a line that connects them. And squeeze right here and make it go up like that. And let's look, we have an A. Okay, and turn over right to left and let's do it again. So let's fold these edges together and these edges together. And here's our point E and our point F. And make a line that attaches them. And squeeze like that. And turn over. And do it again. Squeeze here and here. And make the line that attaches them. And squeeze. And turn over. And just squeeze it together. Like that. And make sure that your arrow looks nice. And there we have it. Okay. So now we need to attach these two together like this. And I have a tutorial of the two interlocking rings. We're going to use the identical lock. So if you want to follow that, it might be a little bit easier. But I'll do my best right now to try to teach this as well. So, okay. Let's rotate. And just pick a side. Let's pick the right side. Okay, we're going to fold this corner up right on this point. So it goes up like that. And now let's fold this triangle right here. Let's fold it over right onto itself through all layers. We're folding right on this edge right here. Just wrapping it over like that. Okay. Now let's unfold here and unfold here. And let's refold on the crease. Okay, so this should be a 45, 45, 90 right triangle. And let's open up this pocket and squash it. And let's take this corner and just the single layer and fold it to the opposite corner. Like that. Okay? And now let's do the same thing on this side. So let's fold this flap up. We're folding right on this point. Folds up like that. And now we're going to fold this triangle over. Fold it right on this edge. Like that. We'll make sure that this comes to a point. Okay, and unfold and unfold. Oops, that can be unfolded. And now let's refold. And open this pocket and flatten. And let's once again fold this flap like this. Now this time we're going to unfold it and we're going to tuck it inside right on this existing crease. So you have to open it up a little bit and just tuck it into the pocket. Like that. Okay? And flatten it. So on this side we have a white square, and on this side we have two triangles. So let's take this flap and we're going to insert it behind this colored triangle right here. Just the single flap. Goes in like that and flatten. Now we're going to fold right on this existing crease, all layers, we just hold them, and we're going to fold this edge to this edge on the existing crease. Like that. Okay? Squeeze, flatten, and unfold. And now, holding these edges together, open this up like that and push this paper inside there. Just push it in like that and close it back up. Okay, and now open it again and lift this layer up, and we have the lock. These two flaps are locked together. And so now we have our hook, our circle, and you can just shape the circle to taste. And there it is. And you can maybe shape it however you want. It's a heart. Ooh, a bouncy heart. And it can also be a hula hoop for your finger. Okay, so if you want to try to put it into the ornament, what you do is you're going to stick it in, right in the side here, because that way it can go all the way in. And now push it in like that. And now it's right like that. And there's the ornament. Now to get it out, good luck. Well, you have to go right over this edge again and just rotate it out like that. All right, well, I hope you guys were able to do that, and let me know what you think. And if you've gotten stuck at a certain place, let me know where, and I'll try to at least put an annotation on it. So, okay. Well, happy holidays. Bye-bye.